Good afternoon, everybody. I'm hoping you can see me at this time. All right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, fine. First, I'd like to say good afternoon to the distinguished guest, the chairperson, Dr. Bunjara, and our Zoom moderators. Thank you very much. As you notice, when you're looking at my name, you see George Cannon, but my paper is written by Peter. I've used a nickname very much like Tides. From birth, I was called Petey, then Pete, and then Peter. I was born in Saudi Arabia. I am an American. And my contact with America was every 2 years, my family would come back to the United States, buy a car on the East Coast, and spend 3 months driving across America. It was there that I discovered AM radio and the beginnings of rock music. My parents wanted me to listen to the music, to sing along, to stimulate my intellect, to help my vocabulary, and I don't think it was to listen to me sing. But that was late 1963. On February 4th, every kid, every teenager in the United States tuned in to the Ed Sullivan Show in order to see the Beatles perform. This was going to be the first time any of us had seen live music played by the artist on TV.
Oh yeah, I'll tell you something. I think you'll understand when I say that something. I wanna hold your hand.
Okay, that changed many a young person's life. Music and teaching and language learning. Music is a useful tool for studying in English by introducing music, songs, and figurative language to the ESL or EFL classroom. A new dimension of learning can be explored. Songs are a source of pleasure, but can also be used as a tool for learning. By using figurative language, a better use of imagination can be conveyed. Songs and music can easily be used to motivate all types of students. As stated by Dunaway in 2010, students will say, "I can't read poetry," or "poetry doesn't make sense." They will never say, "I can't figure out a song," which in reality is simply another form of poetry. In Thailand, learning English through song was given positive feedback by undergraduate students, as they claim that songs allow them to pronounce words more clearly, thus building their confidence. Panarangsaram, a lecturer at Chulalongkorn University in 2000, noted that adjectives like fun and enjoyable were the most commonly used words students had about learning English through songs. Understanding figurative language enhances reading comprehension. Figurative language is found in all types of writing, especially poetry and songs. It creates tone, evokes emotion, and adds a layer of complexity to written words. Students will better understand figurative language and will be able to interpret texts, analyze them on a deeper level. They can understand the writer's choice of words and the overall purpose of the song, story, or poem. This is useful in daily life and for students who would like to take an opportunity to study abroad. It's also very important in understanding and being able to comprehend standardized assessments. The objectives of this study were first to classify the figurative language found into types. 6 types of figurative language were found. They were then classified, analyzed, and interpreted. Most found were metaphors, followed by personification, metonymy, hyperbole, similes, and symbolism. Metaphors were the most found type, which is often common in poetry and songs. To interpret the figurative language meaning, I investigated the background information of the artist. Information on their songs and lifestyle was collected. Historical reference was taken into account, and it was found that most songs dealt with adolescent problems, such as happiness, love, heartbreak, and anger. Regarding methodology, in conducting this research, the descriptive method was used. The researcher chose to use the descriptive method because in analyzing the figurative language, the researcher collected the data by identification and classification. I then analyzed the lexical items in the indie songs of Avril Lavigne, Liam Gallagher, and the band Lani. L-A-N-Y is actually an acronym for Los Angeles and New York. Avril Lavigne is a Canadian singer who was one of the leaders in the indie music movement. Liam Gallagher was a founding member of the British band Oasis, but has since broken off to record on his own. And here you see Lani, once again, Los Angeles and New York. Now, the examples of figurative language were selected to establish the scope of the study, and an in-depth analyzation was done looking for the implicit meaning found in the song lyrics. Now, we're just going to take a quick look here at the results, and I'll expand on this later in my talk. You can see here frequency and types. Metaphors were found the most. Personification, metonymy, and hyperbole were found about equally. Similes were slightly less, and symbolism was found the least. Now, what is figurative language? We have metaphors, personification, metonymy, hyperbole, and similes, and symbolism were found in my study. I'd like to give a brief description of each, since this paper is in some ways written more for students than for teachers. A metaphor is simply a figure of speech that describes an object or action in a way that isn't literally true, but helps explain an idea or make a comparison. So here's a very clear example. Life is a roller coaster. Life has ups and downs. There's good things and bad things. There's thrills, there's boredom. So to explain life is a roller coaster, we know it's not smooth and easy. Personification is in which an idea or thing is given a human attribute and or feeling or is spoken of as if it was human. Personification is a common form of a metaphor in that human characteristics are attributed to non-human things. So lightning danced across the sky. Of course, lightning can't dance across the sky, but in the last few days here in Bangkok, we've seen lightning lighting up the skies and thunder cascading down. So in a sense, lightning can dance across the skies.
Presenter, you have 5 minutes left.
I do. Okay. So metonymy is the substitution of the name or an attribute or adjunct for that thing or thing meant. For example, dish. What dish would you recommend? It doesn't mean a dish or a plate. If you were in America, you might be eating steak and beans. If you were here in Thailand, you'd have tom yum kung. Hyperbole. How many times have you as teachers heard this? I have a ton of homework. You don't have a ton, you have too much. At least you think it's too much. Thai Airways Forever has used a simile, as smooth as silk, describing and comparing two things using as. From the minute you begin your journey to the minute you end your journey will be as smooth as silk. Now, from symbolism, you can see here a winding river. It starts in the mountains and ends in the sea. You're born and you die, and you go through various changes in your life. With regards to frequency, metaphors were found the most in my study, 20 times or 32.5%. Personification was found 11 times or 17.7%. Metonymy 9 times or 14.5. Hyperbole and similes 9 and 8 at 14.5 and 12.9 respectively. And symbolism 5 times at 8%. The example of the metaphor from the collected literature, while their cops are taking over, while everyone is yoga, because happiness is a warm gun. This is a direct reference to the Brexit campaign in England. An unfired pistol is known as cold steel. A fired pistol is known as a warm gun. Oliver from Skater Boy by Avril Lavigne. All of her friends stuck up their nose. They had a problem with his baggy clothes. To stick up your nose is to look down on someone. This reference is that her friends knew the boy was a punk skater, so they didn't appreciate him and told her to leave him. Personification from Breaking in Summer. Throwing bottles in the fire, whiskey's got us singing like a choir. Through the consumption of alcohol, the young people began to sing. And they sounded very much like a choir, a group of people, usually religious, that sing together in a very melodious tone. Metonymy from Let Me Go by Avril Lavigne. Love that once hung on the wall used to mean something. Now it means nothing at all. Right? With regards to this one, right? Love can't hang on a wall, but the pictures that once hung on the wall meant a lot to the songwriter, but now he had to take them down. They're gone because there is no love. Love means nothing at all. The example of hyperbole is from What It's Worth by Liam Gallagher. In my defense, all my intentions were good, and heaven only knows a place somewhere for the misunderstood. You know I'd give you a pint of blood if that would be enough. Well, in this thing, the songwriter is using hyperbole to apologize for past mistakes. The mistakes were made in the form of verbal abuse to those closest to him. In order to atone for these mistakes, he uses hyperbole and the ultimate physical sacrifice, the giving of his own blood to ease those that he's hurt. In the example of symbolism from Breaking in Summer, half my clothes are at your house and I don't want them back. The smell of them is too much. This symbol is the clothes he does not want back. He can smell her scent on the clothes he left at her house. When he uses a sense of smell and other senses, his emotions are triggered and he feels sadness and loneliness because they've broken up and she is gone. He surely does not want these emotions to surface as they cause him emotional pain. In conclusion, the effects of introducing figurative language to the EFL classroom can be of great benefit to the learner. By using songs and music to study figurative language, the students themselves can choose the musical style and the artist that they enjoy the most and are most familiar with. This will increase their desire to get involved in these types of learning, while at the same time making it more enjoyable and fun. By delving deeper into the meaning of the songs and their lyrics, the concept of critical thinking can begin to be introduced. The reasons for the songwriter choosing certain lyrics and styles of figurative language can be studied in much greater depth, for even greater comprehension of the song lyrics. Now, one last rhetorical question before I finish. Do you remember your favorite song from when you were in high school? I bet you do. And if I were to cue that song up right now, I'd also bet you could sing along and recall all your favorite lyrics. You will remember where you were, who you were with, and where you were when you first heard the song. Music, songs, and lyrics have the unique ability to remain with us forever, something that even the best lectures and lessons cannot. So by combining music's ability to be retained with language learning lessons, you can, in a sense, double the value of the educational lesson.
Thank you
very much for listening.
Thank you.
I'm hoping you can see my face.
Yeah, thank you very much. Very impressive. I like all the examples that you give. Well, I have just very little comments. I actually love the study that you are doing here. So I have just little comments. I think you have very clear three objectives, and you are successful in answering all those research questions.
Thank you very much.
So you first classify them, then you examine them, and
yes, ma'am,
then you interpret them. So yeah, you have done all the three objectives thoroughly. So yeah, it's a complete piece of work. Great piece of work. All right. So what I would add more is just something that you might want to think about if you have time, or if you want to have more fun in the future, you might try something like, instead of interpreting the figurative language by yourself, you might have your student with different levels of English proficiency interpret them. And you could find out if student with different proficiency level would have the same or different interpretations.
It's very interesting that you said that, because the basis of the study was my independent study students' papers. And they really enjoy indie music, which I forgot to mention, simply means independent. Independent. They were not signed to a major record label. I got a little bit nervous when either Ajahn Witsanupong or Ajahn Morapong said 5 minutes. I thought I'd been speaking for 5 minutes.
Well, that's okay. You still have the clear picture.
And there's one other thing I'd like to add, which is the fact that the honorable doctor from Kanto University, who is our keynote speaker, I was going to change my conclusion in a sense, because motivation is the key to everything for me with the students, and it's why I use music. Mm-hmm. They're choosing something they like, and if you like something, you want to do it. Mm-hmm. I brought up in a previous session that if they're studying Shakespeare, I don't think after dinner they're going to want to sit down and get into Romeo and Juliet. Mm-hmm. But I think after dinner they would really love to sit down, turn on the music, and follow along with the lyrics.
Yeah.
So it's beneficial to me as the instructor and to the student.
Yeah, for everything, even for me working, for everyone, for their work, they got motivation and they would do a good job. It would just automatically the result from...
Well,
from
motivation in Thailand for me, Ajahn Bunjara, can overcome shyness. I've basically been teaching here forever, and that was my biggest shock when I first began to teach. I'm used to, are there any questions? 35 hands go up, but are there any questions? 35 heads go down.
Yeah,
how can we motivate?
Experience.
How can we motivate?
Mm-hmm.
This is my approach. Mm-hmm. And you were talking about grammar earlier, singer Avril Lavigne. To me, the most difficult structure in English, especially with regards to writing, is simply a, and the.
Mm-hmm.
And the song you saw, Skater Boy, is used for finding a, and the through listening comprehension. Mm-hmm. And this was also a motivating factor in my decision to present this paper.
Good point. Yeah. Okay. Well, good job. Yeah.
Thank you, man. It's been a long 3 months.
We were talking about how young
Ajahn Wissanupong and Ajahn Warporn are. Well, I hold up the elderly side of Mahawithyalaya Rangsitho.
Okay. All right. So if you want to have some more research, I think you can also do something like figurative language at different periods of time, like the figurative language in the song in this decade and in earlier decade, yeah. Like the technology is changing. So yeah, the language that is used might be changing too. So from something like life is a roller coaster, maybe now they have life is a Facebook or something like that.
Yes, very much. Life is social media.
or the picture that you show at the end, like love that once hung on the wall, maybe love that once in the Facebook or something like that.
I was speeding a little bit in there, but I hope I could get the points through.
You can play around if you would like.
Thank you so much, Aja.
Okay, and yeah, so that's all for my comments. And thank you, everyone. Thank you, Rang.